everyone! So today I have a bit of a different video for you guys. It's going to be a product review. This is the first time I do a review, so bear with me. I am going to try my best to give you as much information as I possibly can. And the review that I'm doing is on this product called ThermoMorph. And I've been contacted by the company to give my honest opinion, so that's what I'm going to do. I have tried a few different techniques here. When I received the product, I just had these ideas that I wanted to try out, so I'm going to let you guys know what I did, and then at the end I'll just let you know my overall opinion about the product and what I found while I was working with it. So I hope you guys enjoyed this video, and I'll have a disclaimer and links and more information down in the description below, so please check that out. So the first thing that I did was, of course, to get my product prepared, and the instructions are on the back, so I would recommend that you read the instructions and follow them as it is on the bottle. But just basically, I am putting the product in hot water and letting it melt. And once it melted, I just took it out and I started kneading it, just mixing it together. And I found that some of it was still not melted, so I decided to put it back in the water and let it fully melt. I used my acrylic block here, and some of it did stick to it a little bit, but once the plastic dried, it just came off really easy, and you can kind of see me peeling it off here. So the first technique I wanted to try was to emboss a piece of this plastic. So I ended up using baby talcum powder on my embossing folder just to stop it from sticking very badly. I was worried that that was going to happen, and actually the powder stopped it from happening. It didn't happen at all. So I ran it through my Big Shot machine on embossing settings, of course, and at first I tried with the two cutting plates and it wasn't going through, so I didn't want to force it and break my machine. I ended up just removing one of the plates and then it went through nicely, and you can see it's nicely embossed. Then the second technique I wanted to do is to use a cookie cutter. So I just prepped my acrylic block here with some powder, and I also powdered my cookie cutter. I melted the plastic and then I cut out with the cookie cutter, and I removed the piece when it was still kind of soft, so the shape wasn't very good. It kind of deformed it a little bit. So I tried a second time, and this time I allowed the product to set a little bit harder inside the cookie cutter, and that way it kept its shape a little bit better. I also trimmed the edges because I had some fuzzy edges, and you can kind of see the two together here, the difference. The first one is just really misshapen, and the second one just looks a lot better. So the third technique I wanted to try was, I wanted to find out if I could color this plastic. So I used some distress marker reinker here, and if you don't want to get your fingers messy, I would suggest that you use gloves for this part, but I didn't really care so much, so that's what I did. I just kneaded the plastic time and time again with the ink, and once it started to kind of set a little bit, I put it back in the water and just kneaded some more. And what I wanted to do with this one was to emboss it as well and then cut it with a cookie cutter, so that's what I did. And because I had the embossing there, I did not want to put the plastic in boiling water. I just had warm water, so of course, because it's warm, it's not going to melt the plastic too much, and it will keep the embossing details on there. But the only problem with that is that the cookie cutter didn't cut through all the way, so I just put it back in the water, and then I used my scissors to just cut around that circle that had already been marked with the cutter. And to finish it off, I just cut out a circle just using the end of a pen here, just so that I can use this as a tag or maybe even as a pendant. Now the next thing that I wanted to try is just to cut something by hand, and I just simply cut out a heart shape, and I just eyeballed it. I didn't do anything fancy, and because the heart wasn't exactly the shape that I wanted, the great thing about this product is that you can kind of shape it into how you want it to look. So I just did that with my fingers. I just pushed it around a little bit, and then I trimmed with my scissors so that it looked a little bit more rounded and more heart-like. So then after I finished playing with the product and testing out the techniques that I wanted to do. I wanted to see if I could color these with different kind of inks and things. And the first thing that I did was I used alcohol ink, and I just used that, and I actually really like how that looks. It gave me a kind of a watercolor effect, which I really liked. And just as watercolor, you can kind of like see through a little bit, so it's not really opaque, and I actually really like that. So that was the first one. The second one, I ended up using nail polish, and that was the heart that you see me doing here. I ended up using two coats of the nail polish, and that's actually probably down to my nail polish. It's probably not a very opaque one. So I just waited for the first layer to dry and then did another coat. And I did the same thing on that big piece. I just use the black nail polish for that one. Then for the second butterfly, I ended up trying out acrylic paint, and I just covered the whole thing, and I ended up just doing one coat on that one. And you could of course use any kind of other inks or paints that you have, but these are the ones that I use. And for the last piece, which is that rounded one, all I did was I just used some clear nail varnish. Okay, and here I just wanted to share with you guys a couple of projects that I have made using some of the pieces that I created with this product. So I've made two cards here with the butterflies that I made. So you guys remember that this butterfly I had alcohol inked, and so it has this kind of like watercolor kind of a look to it, and that's why I ended up using some watercolor technique for the background. So I just made a simple card, used some sequins there and just some ink, a little sentiment. And this one's pretty much a very similar card, and this is the one that I painted in white, so that's what it looks like. These two I haven't used yet, but I'll probably use this one on a card or a tag or something like that as well. And this one, of course, the idea was to create a little tag for a gift or even a pendant or something like that. So I still have to create that. And here is a project that I have created with the bigger piece, which is the one that I embossed. And you guys might remember that one. And I painted that one with nail varnish in black. And I used it on the back here, and I just created this cute little box, which is for Father's Day. So I ended up, of course, using the word dad here. And I used one of these metal embellishments from my stash. And I just think it kind of coordinates with that embossing folder that I used. So you can kind of see there on the background, and I really like how that looks. So I just created this origami box, and I have a tutorial on how to make this box in case you guys want to recreate one. And I'll link it below if you want to check that out. And all I did was I just created this kind of like explosion look to the front of the box and place that piece underneath, and then I created this banner to go on top, and I really like how that came out. I think it's really masculine, and of course you can use this in whatever project you would like. This is just how I decided to use my pieces. I just really wanted to give you guys some inspiration and some ideas, but of course you can create whatever you want with these. Okay, so I thought I would make a little list of pros and cons, and this is strictly my opinion. This is how I feel about the product and the things that I found using the product. Of course, people have different opinions, but this is just my opinion. So the first thing that I thought was definitely a pro is versatility. So the product can be used for many different types of crafts, and you can definitely use this with molds, and you can create your own shapes, you can emboss, you can cut, you can do all sorts of things with this. I do like that it's very versatile. I also like the value for money. I know that there are similar products out there that may be a little bit similar or seem to be a little bit less expensive, but I personally wouldn't want to use a product that is not branded. And you know, it's just a peace of mind, really. I just feel like if something went wrong or I had a major problem with the product, where would I go to make a complaint or anything like that? So that's just my personal opinion. I would actually rather pay a little bit more and have something branded that, you know, I can then look into the company, and the company has a reputation and all of that good stuff. So I definitely think this is value for money. I don't think it's really that expensive. I think that you get a lot for your money, and I have used quite a lot of the product and I still have almost a full tub left. So I can see that I can use this for a long, long time. The next thing that I have put on my list here is that it's easy to use, and actually when I received the product, before I read the instructions, I thought it was going to be something super complicated, but actually it's really not. It literally is, you know, getting the temperature of the water right and putting your product in there and then get using. So it really is that simple. The next thing on my list is the fumes. I also was a little bit concerned about smells, and I know sometimes we buy a product to try with crafts and then we find that it has a really strong smell. I personally don't really like really smelly or any product that has a really strong fume. I just feel like if you're using that very often, it might just be harmful for you on the long term. So I wouldn't personally like to use a product like that. So this is one thing that I like with the ThermoMorph. I found that there's no smells, so that's definitely a pro. I also liked a very lightweight, so if you're using on a card or something like that, you can definitely mail it, as long as you don't make it too bulky or too thick or anything like that. But weight wise, it's definitely really light, so definitely a bonus. I like that it can be painted, so you can definitely use different kinds of paints and inks and things like that to get your own personalized and whatever color you'd like, really. I like that it can be reused, and by that I actually mean reshaped. So if you made something that you don't really like, you can definitely put it back in the hot water and it will melt again. So you can't really waste the product unless you've already painted it or something like that. I actually painted some of my pieces with nail varnish, so I'm sure that would probably mess it up and I wouldn't be able to reuse those. But I would definitely only paint something once I'm happy with it. So if I don't really like the shape, I wouldn't go ahead and paint or ink or do anything like that. I would just put it in the water again and do it again, really. And the last thing that I wanted to mention is this fast drying. And the reason I kept this last is because I see that as a pro, but I also see that as a con. So I personally think that if you're impatient like me, it's definitely a good thing to have something that dries really fast like this. And I don't see it as a major issue, just because, like I said, you can definitely put it in the water and it will remelt, so it's not a big deal. But of course, you have to be someone that works fast. And if you don't really like to work fast, then that's why I have this on the cons list. Some people actually like to work slowly and, you know, just calmly and take their time and enjoy what they're doing. So I don't know if this would really be very useful for those kind of people. But I definitely feel like it's worth a try. So if you're thinking of trying this product, I definitely would give it a go. Another one on my list of cons is that this product shouldn't really be used with kids. I mean, it's obviously up to every individual, you know, if you want to use it with your kids. I personally don't think I would use it with very young kids, just because of the hot temperature of the water. I don't think it would be very safe and they might end up getting hurt, so I wouldn't really do that myself. But again, like I said, you want to supervise your kids, and if they're a little bit older and they're careful, then I don't think that that would be a major problem. And the last thing on my list of cons, I actually found it was a little bit tricky to color the actual plastic itself. As I mentioned, you could definitely paint it and use all sorts of things to color on the outside, but if you want to color the actual plastic itself, you guys probably saw on my video that the ink that I used didn't really color very well. Now, I haven't actually tried with other inks, so I can't say for sure that it wouldn't work better with other inks like dye inks or something like that. But it's definitely worth a try. If you're thinking of doing that, I would definitely give it a go with other kinds of inks, and maybe it would just do a better job. So anyways, you guys, I hope you enjoyed this review. This is actually my honest opinion. I'm not being paid to do this video. I was sent the product and I was asked to give my honest opinion and just first unbiased review. So that's what that is. And I hope you guys found it useful. So if you guys have any questions, please comment below and let me know. If you like this video, please give it a thumbs up. And I will be back with more videos very soon. Thanks for watching. Bye.